Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add Google Tag Manager to Squarespace. This can help streamline the management of the different analytics and marketing tags that you need to install, including Google Analytics, Google Ads, and more. Now, the first step is to create a Google Tag Manager account. I've included a link to this website where you can create your account in the description below this video. So let's take a look. So the first thing that we need to do is name our account. I suggest naming your Google Tag Manager account like you would your Google Analytics account. So typically this will be the name of your business or organization. So I'm going to name mine Loves Data. We now need to select our country. I'm going to select Australia for mine. And then we need to choose if we're going to share data anonymously with Google and other products. I'm going to opt in. The next step is to create your container. Now, your container is really going to be what you're installing on Squarespace. Again, I recommend naming this after your business or organization. You can also use your website's URL. So let's put in our website's URL, and we're going to select web as the type of platform we're tracking because Squarespace is a website. Now let's click create. So what this will do is once we've agreed to the terms of service is it's going to give us our container. And this is actually what we need to install on Squarespace to begin using Google Tag Manager. So here we can see it's about to pop up. It's just loading up for us. And now we're going to, most importantly, copy this code at the top. This is the JavaScript container code for Google Tag Manager. I'm just going to click on the copy button. And now we're going to head to Squarespace. Now there's a couple of steps. The first thing we need to do to install Google Tag Manager on Squarespace is we need to select website on the top left corner. Then we need to select pages, and then you need to scroll right to the bottom. If you have a lot of pages, it's going to take a little scroll down to the bottom there, and then we're going to select website tools. Now what we can choose is code injection. Now code injection allows us to add code to all of the pages on our Squarespace site. Now for Google Tag Manager, really importantly, we want to install it in the header section. So now we're going to paste the code that we copied from Google Tag Manager, and now we can click on save. So this now means that we have the empty Google Tag Manager container installed on Squarespace. So what we want to do now is probably add some tags into Google Tag Manager because it helps streamline the management of our tags. So one thing I want you to do is now come back and actually check to see if you already have Google Analytics installed using the built-in integration. So we come right back and then we select on settings. So if we come into settings, we're then looking for developer tools, and then we're looking for external API keys. This is where we can find our Google Analytics integration. So what we can see here is we do actually have Google Analytics already installed on our website, on our Squarespace site, using the built-in integration. So now we need to decide how we're going to be using Google Tag Manager. If we're not going to be using Google Tag Manager to install Google Analytics, then you can leave this here. However, if you want to move Google Analytics into Google Tag Manager, we will want to remove this once we've actually published our container. So let's copy this. This is actually our measurement ID from Google Analytics. And now let's head to Google Tag Manager. So if we install this top piece of code in the head section of our Squarespace site, there is another piece of code you can add. This is the NoScript code. I just want to highlight this is rarely used. In 99% of the websites that I've looked at, nobody actually uses this option. So you're quite okay to skip this. So I'm going to click on OK. Now the next step is to create a tag. So if we click on tags, we can then see if there's any tags in our Google Tag Manager container already. Now we know we just created this container, so it is blank, but it's worth checking. So now what we can do is we can click on new and we can create a new tag. I'm going to be using the Google tag to add Google Analytics 4, which is the latest version of Google Analytics to the website in order to track page views. So I'm going to name my tag Google tag GA4 page view. Now let's select tag configuration. Now you can either select Google Analytics and then Google Tag, or you can just select Google Tag straight away. And then tag ID, we can paste in the measurement ID that we copied from the built-in integration for Google Analytics. So we can do that here. Now, if you're not currently using Google Analytics on your Squarespace site, to find your measurement ID, just open up Google Analytics. And then you can navigate to admin, and you can either select data streams once you've navigated to admin, or you can select data collection and then data streams. They'll take you to the same place. From here, we can then find the data stream that we've actually created inside Google Analytics. Now, if you are just getting started with Google Analytics for the first time and you don't have a data stream, then check out my dedicated Google Analytics tutorial. I've included a link in the description below this video. It guides you through how to get started with Google Analytics. So I'm assuming because you're looking to use Google Tag Manager, you've already followed these steps. If not, then please do check out the other tutorial. So now what we can do is we can select the data stream, and this is just another place where we can find our measurement ID. So you can copy it here as well if you're not using this option already inside Squarespace. So once we've pasted the measurement ID, we then need to choose a trigger. This controls when we're going to fire that tag on our Squarespace site. There are three predefined triggers. The one that's going to fire our tag on all of our pages first is the initialization all pages trigger. So this will fire our tag before other tags are fired on our website, with the exception of any consent tags. For example, if we're using a cookie consent banner. So now we have our measurement ID in the Google tag, and we've selected initialization all pages, so we can now click on save. So at this point, what you could do is you could go ahead and add in any other tags that you want to configure inside Google Tag Manager. Now, the next step is one that's important, is to test our tags. So inside Google Tag Manager, we're going to click on Preview to test our tags. This will open a new tab for Tag Assistant. And from here, we can now enter the URL of our Squarespace site. So I'm going to enter in my Squarespace site, which is lovesdata-test.com, and I'm going to click Connect. This will now open one more tab in our browser, and this will actually be a preview of our website. We can see on the bottom right-hand corner, Tag Assistant has loaded. We can now browse through our website. We can complete other actions to test things out in Google Tag Manager if we were tracking any other actions. And then we can check the Tag Assistant tab. So if I click on the Tag Assistant tab, I can now see that my Google tag has fired for the two different pages that we viewed. So that's looking good so far. Now, if we actually look at the measurement ID for Google Analytics, we've viewed two pages, but you'll actually notice there's four page views. And that's because I still have that inbuilt integration enabled inside Squarespace. So what we want to do is we only really want two page views for the two pages we viewed, right? So what we need to do is this. We need to come into Google Tag Manager. We're going to click on Submit on the top right-hand corner. This will publish our tags, triggers, and variables through to our Squarespace site. So I'm going to give it a name. I'm going to say added Google tag for, of course, Google Analytics. I'm going to click on Publish. This now means that it's being pushed to our live website. So we're going to see in a moment that it's published. So now it is actually published on our live website. So now what we need to do is immediately go into Squarespace. We need to remove that measurement ID from the inbuilt integration and click on save. And what this will mean now is that now that we've removed the measurement ID, we're only tracking each page once inside Google Analytics. So that's an important step to take if you are going to be installing Google Tag Manager on your Squarespace site. Now, the other thing that I did also want to show you is that if you are actually selling products on your Squarespace site, then Google Tag Manager is a little bit limited. So these are the details that you can actually send to Google Tag Manager from Squarespace in order to track transactions. We can capture the order ID, the total amount, and that's pretty much it. So just please be aware that if you're looking to track transactions through Google Tag Manager from your Squarespace site, there are some limitations. I've included a link to this article, which explains the options that you do have available for tracking e-commerce transactions. And again, you can find the link in the description below this video. So that's how you can add Google Tag Manager to your Squarespace site. If you would like to learn even more about Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics, then please take a moment to check out my courses. I've included links to them in the description below this video. If you haven't already, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.